Sean, do you have a mascot?
Yeah, I do, Jimmy, yeah. I don't think you might have noticed about me over the years that I don't do many adverts.
I've noticed that, yeah.
And it's not an ethical, it's not a moral thing. I just have never found a product to which I feel I can really commit myself. Recently, I've launched my own website and my own business, and I feel like I should be the voice of this new business. So, and I'd actually like, I thought it might be a bit of fun to do it for you. I'd like to record my ad for you with the voiceover. Okay, let's do this. Let's do this. Need some money? Got an old canal boat lying around? Then phone me, the captain, and I'll turn your floating rat trap into hard cash or gold. webuyanycanalboat.com. We'll pay good money for all canal-worthy craft, with or without a certificate of canal-worthiness. Visit one of our friendly flagship canal boat valuation centres. We're very easy to find, even in the fog. Or just send us a rough estimate of your mounting debts. Turn your unwanted craft into cash or gold. At webuyanycanalboat.com, we put the can into canal and the anal boat into canal boat. Terms and conditions may apply. All craft must be delivered to our valuation centre at owner's expense using our in-house transportation fleet. At webuyanycanalboat.com, we reserve the right not to buy any canal boat. Initial offer may seem much bigger than actual payment received. We are members of ABTA, but as we're not travel agents, it's useless. By agreeing to watch this advert, your house may be at risk. Calls charged at proper premium rates. Callers must be 8 years or older and do not need the bill payer's permission. Just pick up the phone, dial the number, and then go out and play. Nothing the captain says, does, writes, or thinks is legally binding.
Sean, let's have that, everyone.
Sean, have you got a mascot?
Well, I haven't got a mascot so much as I'd like to start a new craze.
Oh.
Last year was the year of the ice bucket challenge.
Of course, huge.
And personally wasn't that impressed. You know, a bit of cold water on you doesn't really make any difference. So I've come up with a new craze I want to pass on to raise money. And it's the cat litter challenge. I'm going to tip this pile of cat litter over me to raise money for, I don't know, some kind of... I don't know, I don't like cats, so something that...
some worthy charity.
For men clearly going through some sort of breakdown?
Yeah, all right. Yeah.
Can I just pledge £100?
Yeah, pledge £100. Well, actually, I've got to nominate after this.
You're not actually going to do, are you? Why would you do that?
Oh, Jesus. Ready? One, two, three. Shove their bush tucker trials up their little Geordie cat's bums. Oh, I've been stuck on my finger! So anyway, I've obviously got to nominate two people.
Quite a lot of that's gone down the back of your shirt.
I know. But it's worth it, it's for a good cause. I'm nominating Anna Wintour, the editor of Vogue. Rachel, you'd like it.
No.
No, I don't expect anyone else to do it. Obviously, it's too far.
I may actually have a bit of cat shit on me anyway.
It never occurred to me when I was leaving the area to take my water with me.
Anyway, I'll just stand for it. Any wet wipes?
No, sure. No, you've made your bed, you will lie in it. Just sit there in your cat shit and think about what you've done. I mean, you've had some crazy ideas.
I've got it all down my trousers now.
What did our production crew say to you when you said, I need... What are you doing? What are you doing? Sure, can you just pop your mic on?
I don't know where it's gone.
check. It's probably...
I've stuffed it down.
Imagine some poor sound man's listening to it. Is that his bollock?
Would it be unreasonable to ask for another glass of water?
I like the idea that somebody just tunes in now. And sees my desk. That's you!
I was lucky enough to be sent recently a copy of a newspaper from the day I was born. 22nd of April, 1963. And here we go, it's the simpler times. And as you can see, some interesting news going on. The ladder crisis had deepened at that point. And as you can see, the national joy as felt tip pens are invented. We're lucky enough, this day is quite an auspicious day, 22nd of April, because it's the day they announced the finalists for the cheekiest chimney sweep competition. So that's another lovely little part of the newspaper. I mean, here, scientists say we're just 10 years away from dry roasted peanuts. PC goes mad. This is about a police constable who went mad. Look at him, you can see he's on the turn there.
Is that, what's the other story at the bottom there?
I think Carol Vorderman joins Countdown, is there?
This is a story about the Horsham Warbler.
Well, there was a fashion for gentlemen to warble under women's windows.
To warble, sorry?
Yeah, sort of go... Unsolicited warbling. And there's a story about foreign muck. Food survey suggests foreign muck becoming more popular than our traditional boiled stuff. And on the back page, on the sports here, we've got this thing about tennis umpires remain grounded due to deepening ladder crisis. There's one other article I want to find, because it's about... It's the Beatles album, first album, was released that week, and there's a really good piece in here about it. Beatles to release their first album.
Is there a story on the other side of that?
No. Why don't I get more acting work?
John Locke's newspaper from the day of his birth.
Well, Jimmy, I've decided to make, if you'd like to help me, Fabio, bring on my Countdown cocktail I'm going to make, which is a cocktail made from drinks from every letter of the alphabet. Thank you, dear.
I mean, if this is genuine booze, we're already in a lot of trouble.
So here we go. And I've got, a special glass for it to be in. This is the making of the Countdown cocktail. I've obviously tried it. It's delicious. We start with some, just as a base drink, we just have a bit of amaretto. That's like that. That's A for amaretto.
A fine base, yeah, lovely. A.
And then there's some umbongo.
It was beautifully poured there. Yeah. Like something from cocktail.
C, cheeky half. Dr. Pepper, lovely. Balances the flavours. What's on every cocktail these days? Espresso. And then some vodka. Oh, just a little.
Yeah.
Then there's the guest ale.
Oh, not the whole thing. Interesting.
God, no. And then a half. And then, of course, what do you need for every cocktail? You need some ice, don't you? One, two. Hey, it's party time. Three. Chin.
Chin, did you say?
Pardon, what did you say?
What was that?
Chin.
Chin.
Then, of course, K is Kiora.
Has that been watered down at all, or is that neat?
That's neat.
Oh, is that double concentrate we're looking at?
Oh. Oh, sure. Oh, that's easy.
I'm not drinking the toilet cleaner. God, just about take off the edge off the gin. OK, so what do you have after K? A very, very fine drink, Liebfraumilch, which is the milk of a loved woman. There we go. We've got right to M. Mead.
Oh, I like it.
You'll like
meat.
That, actually. You should try some of that. Nice. And then N is nog without the egg.
Oh. That's curdled it up real nice, that.
N, what's next? O, ouzo. I only put this in to help the Greek economy. P, lovely bit of pesto.
And how much do you put in just one finger's worth?
Yeah, just a finger flick.
Just a pinch.
Q's Cointreau.
Delicious.
This would be an ideal drink to have if you're just meeting up with a couple of friends and going to the theatre or the cinema. You'd have one of these.
Nothing too fussy.
Before, if you're going to see a sort of like a drama, Shakespeare play or something like that, and you wanted something just to sort of like take the edge off the day. R, rest of the bottle. Anything you've got knocking round at home, whatever it is.
That's why it's always different. That's the fun. That's half the fun.
S, champagne. There we go. T, some tea. Not too much tea. Can really kill a good cocktail with tea. V, Vimto. Oh, yeah. Again, creates a lot of balance.
And colour don't change, does it?
W, I think no cocktail, no alpha, no piano cocktails satisfied without a couple of whelks in it. X is X. And that is very close to being made. And we just have one last ingredient here, which is really healthy, is the Yakult. Finally, zest of lemon, but not too much. You don't want to overpower the flavour. There we go. There
a bit of lime. Lime. Okay.
Lime. Sorry, best zest of lime. Oh, that whole thing's wasted. Oh, forget it. Move on. No. I forgot to put the U, umbrella. Then you just have a straw.
Oh, mate.
Oh. There's two whelks in there.
It could do with a little bit more tea.
I kind of want to try it.
Did you like to try it?
Just yeah.
Try some. I've got some straws here. Please do.
You need a knife
That's
and
the
fork.
Spirit. I'd like to try a real sip. What do you think?
I've had worse.
Well, we could do this romantic thing where we drink it together. 3 Mile Island iced tea.
No, what a bit of
You mess with well.
Oh, you got well through a straw. So
with every cocktail, you get a towel.
Yeah, just less egg next time.
Okay.
A bit more Kiora.
Would anyone like some?
Oh, yeah, a whelk in there.
Yeah, put a whelk in.
Right, I'll put it there on the side.
If any of that goes on me, this is over.
This is like your worst nightmare, this, isn't it, John?
End of that whelk looks like an anus that's been done up on time.
He's just retired from the porn industry.
Sean's cocktail, everyone.
Do you know what I've realised, right? In this day and age, everyone's on the internet. Like a motorbike, isn't it? The internet. Um, you go into your local news agent, and there is just you go to I won't say the full name, W. Smiths, right? Or somewhere like that. They've got hundreds of magazines, and I still think to myself, they're really specialised. I think there's money to be made out there. So I've invested money in bought a little publishing company, and I've got a roster of magazines that I'm producing. This is and it's very incredibly lucrative. I didn't realise just how much money there is in magazines. It's quite a long build-up, isn't it?
It better be funny.
Well, that's probably why I'm taking so long, because I'm feeling a bit cocky.
Feeling a bit cocky is probably one of the magazines, is it?
Can't help it, can you?
It's a gift. It's a gift.
It's a gift. Anyway, so the first one is The Wall magazine. And that's just about bricklaying. And that comes with a free brick. And if you collect all of the all of the issues, you can build your own wall. This next magazine is very popular because there's a lot of these out there and there wasn't a publication for them. It's called The Lapsed Catholic. There we are. And there's interview. Johnny Vegas, Roberto Baggio, Tom Cruise, Lady Gaga. And mostly it's a directory for drugs, booze and sex, to be honest. No, that's the idea for that, but a popular publication. Now, this magazine, this has been a massive hit. Right?
Right.
It's Busty Foster Mummers. And... shelves. You can have that on the lowest shelf because there's no nudity or anything in it. It's just lovely mums who you'd like to foster you. And then I thought, you know, there's a trend for magazines, those celebrity magazines where they point out flaws in celebrities. You know, they sort of point out cellulite and stuff like that for celebrities. I thought, let's do that, but with ordinary women. So I created. Look at the state of her magazine. Real women shamed. 32 quid.
Shorts magazines, everyone. So, John and Sarah are in the lead. Sean, what are you reading?
Oh, it's just another one of these magazines I've got out at the moment.
What's the
magazine? Well, you know, there's a lot of consumer magazines out there.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. Well, it's hard to know sometimes which is the right consumer magazine for you. So I've created What Witch magazine. I've just got a growing empire. This is Tim magazine. It's just stuff about Tims. any Tim you could think of.
I would have said it had been a quiet year for Henman, but he's still one Tim of the year.
Yeah.
You know. Who was he up against this year?
The Tim.
who came second in that?
Mallet.
Brooke Taylor.
Timmy Mallet is in there. It's Tim. Well, it's a bit of a cheat, but we've got Justin Timberlake. And then the final magazine. Now, there's money in porn, we all know that. And I thought to myself, I want to provide a service which isn't provided for. So I created this magazine, it's called Red Hot Sex. It's basically, it's people with the flu. I mean, look at the state of him. He has to do a whole coach load of sick nanas.
I didn't think you were going there with it.
So, you know, it's people with the flu having sex. What could be more fun than that?
And you managed to get Novak Djokovic.
Yeah. Well, he's a dirty bastard.
Sean's magazines, everyone.
Sean's magazines. Just retired from the porn industry.